the Lord has promised good to me. His word, my hope secures. He will my share and portion me as long as life.
It's good to be coming your way today. We appreciate you watching. We always enjoy, you know, getting to come and be with you. We make this announcement real quick. Me and Steve have a show on Bible prophecy, and it comes on Sunday night at 8 o'clock. We'd love for you to watch. I believe that you'd enjoy it. And every Sunday night at 8 o'clock. So if you get a chance, watch it. Also, give you an invitation. Come be with us at Lacy's Chapel. You go to Henninger Crossing and go west like you're going to Scottsboro, and the church is 3 miles on your left. And we'd love to have you. Always, you know, enjoy. Seem like every week we have visitors that come in, and we give you an invitation to come be with us. And, you know, God is blessing this church, and they're just really some good people that's going to this church. So we give you an invitation to come be with us, and we'd love to have you. If you got your Bible today, we're going to be reading from Matthew chapter 6. We've been preaching about bearing fruit for the past 3 or 4 weeks. But I want to talk today about bearing fruit. But I want to talk about eternal fruit, bearing fruit that will be with you in eternity. So, Matthew chapter 6, verse 19, Jesus said this. He said, "Lay up not for yourselves treasures upon earth, where moth and rust does corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust does corrupt, where thieves do not break through and steal." So Jesus is talking about laying up your rewards, or laying up your treasures. For he said, "For where your treasure is, there will be your heart also." So Jesus is saying, he's not saying, of course, it's wrong to have money or to have wealth. He's not saying it's wrong to have wealth. But he's saying this wealth that we have in this life is temporal. It's not going to last. You know, a really thought to think about is when we die, we carry absolutely nothing with us. I mean, as far as possessions of this world, we carry absolutely nothing with us. If we own land or cattle or whatever you may own, we carry absolutely none of that with us. But there is a way for us to lay things up in heaven, and it's by being obedient to God and being faithful to God, and also by our giving. So Jesus said, "Lay not up for yourselves treasures upon earth, where moth and rust does corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal." He's saying that's not to be your primary concern, is your treasures here on this earth, because they're all temporal. You know, anything that one of the Vanderbilts died, and I read this, and I don't remember if it was Cornelius, but it was one of the Vanderbilts that died, and he was very, very, very wealthy. And, you know, he had just died, and the doctor walked out of the room, and one of the nephews said, "What did he leave?" I mean, the guy just died. The nephew said, what did he leave? The doctor said he left it all. Said he left it. And that's true of each one of us. I mean, when we really stop and we really think that nothing that we own, absolutely nothing that we own here on this earth, are we going to carry with us. It's all going to be left behind. But Jesus is saying, don't lay up for yourselves treasures upon earth. He said, don't let that be your primary concern. Verse 20, but lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven. So Jesus said that we can lay up treasures in heaven. You know, we've been speaking about rewards, how that God is going to reward us. But Jesus said, lay up your treasures in heaven. That was a command. Lay up treasures in heaven. And what you lay up in heaven, what you lay up in heaven is what you're going to have for eternity. Now, I'm talking if you're a Christian, if you're lost, you need to be saved. You need to ask Jesus to come into your heart and be your Lord and Savior. You need to be saved. You'll not go to heaven unless you are saved. But if you're a Christian, we're commanded, lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven. That's a command. Jesus said, lay up treasures in heaven. And how you do that is by your service to God, what you do for God, what you do for others. Well, if you help another person, you know, you're really doing it for God. That's what Jesus said in Matthew 25. He says, you know, when I was hungry, you fed me, and I was naked, you clothed me, and I was in prison, you visited me. And they said, Jesus, when did we do this to you? And he said, when you done it to the least of these, my brethren, you done it unto me. But the Bible said, lay up your treasures in heaven. And that's eternal. But verse 21 says, for where your treasures is, there will be your heart also. Where you have your wealth is where your heart is. Well, God is saying, I want your heart. Lay up your treasures in heaven, where heaven becomes real to you, heaven becomes valuable to you. You know, when Jesus taught, he taught so many times about eternity. It's amazing if you will take his teachings and just circle or put a mark by every time he refers to eternity. It's amazing how many times Jesus told those people that he was teaching about eternity. You know, like in John 14, in my Father's house are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you. He's talking about eternity. He's talking about eternity here. Lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven. This speaks of eternity, that we're going to be with him in eternity. Then the treasures or rewards that we have in heaven, we lay them up now. Now is the time that we lay them up. You know, you're not going to lay them up after you die. The Bible said, you know, behold, night cometh. Jesus said this, when no man worketh. I mean, he said, work while it is day, for night cometh when no man is worked. This is me and your hour to lay up our treasures. This is me and your hour to serve God. This is me and your hour to be faithful to God and lay up the rewards or the treasures that we'll have in heaven. Jesus said, for where your treasures is, there will be your heart also. Well, if you take a Christian that, you know, is heavenly minded and he's been faithful to God and he lays up rewards for heaven and, you know, he's gave unto God's work. He's helped others. He's been faithful to God. Well, you know, his heart is in heaven. He's thinking about heaven and what he's got laid up there. But I want to show you where Paul talked about this to a church. And this is really good right here. It's in Philippians chapter 4. Paul is writing to the Philippian church, and this church, the Philippian church, I read this, it said it was one of the poorest churches in the Bible. The Philippian church wasn't a wealthy church, it's what one of my commentaries said. He said, now you Philippians know that in the beginning of the gospel, when I departed from Macedonia, no church communicated with me as concerning giving and receiving, but you only. So he writes to this church, and he says, when I left Macedonia, no church, the word communicated means shared with me or gave to me. It's what Paul writes to this church. No church communicated or shared or gave unto me as concerning giving and receiving, but you only. So Paul writes to this church. It wasn't the wealthiest church by no means. It was one of the poorer churches. But Paul said to the Philippian church, he said, you're the church that gave to me. You're the church that shared with me concerning giving and receiving. So this church supported Paul's ministry. Now, this is going to say some things here that is really good. He says, for even in Thessalonica, you sent once and again unto my necessity or my need. He said, even when I went into another city, you sent an offering unto me that I needed. Or he said, even in Thessalonica, you sent once and again unto my needs or my necessity or my needs. So this church really loved Paul, and they sent a gift to him, even in another city, to help him. Now listen to what Paul said. Paul said, not because I desire a gift. Paul said, I didn't receive this from you because I desire a gift. Now listen to what Paul says, because this is good. Paul said, but I desire fruit that may abound to your account. Paul said, I desire fruit that may abound to your account. He's not talking about their earthly account. He's talking about their heavenly account. Paul said, I took this offering from you because I wanted fruit in your heavenly account, or I wanted you to have rewards, or I wanted you to have treasures in your heavenly account. Paul told this church that God was keeping a record, that God was keeping an account of this church. He told the people in this church, I received a gift from you because I wanted something that was going to be on your heavenly account. He's not talking about their account here on earth. He's talking about their account in heaven. He said, I desire fruit that may abound to your account. Well, Paul is talking here about laying up your treasures in heaven. He's talking to hear what Jesus said. And I just read where Jesus said, and I read again, lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven where neither moth nor rust is corrupt and where thieves do not break through and steal. For where your treasures is, there's your heart also. Jesus said, lay up your treasures in heaven. That is command that he gave to us. We lay up our treasures by serving God, by serving others, and by giving. That's how you lay up your treasures. He said, lay up your treasures in heaven. Jesus came from heaven. If anybody could speak about what's in heaven, it was Jesus. He came from there, and he told these people, lay up your treasures in heaven. He said, for where your treasures is, there will be your heart also. In other words, Jesus is telling them, I want you to be heavenly minded. I want you to think about eternity. Think about God. But he told this church right here, I desire a gift, not because I desire a gift, but I desire fruit that may abound to your account or may be added to your account. Paul was talking about their treasures in heaven. He was talking about their bank account in heaven. And he said, I desired fruit that would abound or be added to your account. Paul, the word abound means to grow or to be added to or to grow. Paul said, I desire the fruit that may be added to your account. Paul was telling this church, when you stand before God, I want you to have treasures in heaven. When you stand before God, I want you to have treasures in heaven. He is saying exactly the same thing that Jesus said in Matthew chapter 6, verse 19 and 20. Paul says exactly the same thing. He just used different words. But he's telling this church, I want you to have a healthy account in heaven. I want you to have an account in heaven. You know, I mean, you have to understand this that when Paul is talking to this church, now listen to what I'm going to say to you because this is important. When Paul is talking to this church, he's talking about heaven. He's talking about what they're going to receive in heaven. And he said, the reason I took this gift from you was not for myself. I wanted you to have treasures in heaven. I wanted something that would abound or be added to your heavenly account. Well, the Bible says, you know, that Jesus said, behold, I come quickly and my reward is with me. The Bible said every man shall be rewarded according to his own works. I'm flipped to that and read it to you. I mean, we're going to be rewarded for it. You don't earn your salvation. The Bible said, Ephesians 2, it's not of works, lest any man should boast. But God does teach us that when he comes back, that he's going to reward every man according to his own works. Here's what it said. Listen what it says in First Corinthians chapter 3, verse 8, he that planteth and he that watereth are one. You know, it's talking about where you plant or where you water, where you preach or teach or sing or whatever you may do, we're one. We're serving God. We're being one mind and one accord. We're doing it for one purpose, and that's to serve God. But he said, every man shall receive his own reward according to his own labor. That's what Paul wrote to the Corinthian church. He said, every man, now let me say this again. The Bible said it's not of works. By grace are ye saved through faith. It's not of works, lest any man should boast. Nobody is saved by works. You're saved by putting your faith in Jesus Christ. That's how we're all saved. The Bible said it's not of works. But the Bible also says in Romans 7, we were saved unto good works. We were saved for good works is what that means. We were saved to serve God. And he said, every man shall receive his own reward according to his own labor. God said, he's talking to the church here. This is what Paul wrote to the church. Everybody will receive a reward according to his own labor. Every man, here's what it said, every man shall receive his own reward according to his own labor. I won't receive my son's reward. I won't receive my dad's reward. I receive my reward, what I have done since I've been saved. That's what Paul wrote to the church. Every man shall receive his own reward. You cannot get no simpler than that. You cannot put it more simple than that. Everyone shall receive his own reward. Then it said, according to his own labor. I mean, that is as simple. That is, you know, go to college, you take English 101. Well, this is 101. This is as simple as you can get it. Every man shall receive his own reward according to his own labor. Well, Jesus said, lay up your treasures in heaven. Paul wrote to the church in Philippians 4, I desire not a gift for myself, but it may abound to your account. Paul was saying, I wanted you to give so it would abound or it would be added to your heavenly account. The Bible says, every man shall receive his own reward according to his own labor. Now listen what he said, let me just read this real quickly. He said, for we're laborers together with God. We're workers together with God. Jesus said, without me you can do nothing. God has to be in it. I mean, God has to help us. God has to give us the strength, the ability, the desire to do what he's called us to do. For your labors together with God, you're God's husbandry, you're God's building. According to the grace of God, which giveth unto me as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation, and another buildeth their own. But listen to what he says. Let every man take heed how he builds their own. Paul is saying, Jesus is the foundation. But he's saying, after you're saved, take heed how you build on that foundation. And in other words, he's talking here about laboring for God. He that planted, he that worketh the one, every man shall receive his own reward according to his own labor. He's saying, you're going to be rewarded for what you do. Jesus said, behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me. That's what Jesus said. Behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me. And he said, every man shall be rewarded according to his own labor. Well, but he said, let every man take heed how he builds their own. After you get saved, God is saying, take heed the life that you live. Are you being faithful to God? Are you serving God? Are you serving others? Are you giving to God's work? Well, if you do those things, you're laying up your treasures in heaven, which all of us are going to get soon. We're all headed that way. Every single one of us are headed to the judgment seat of Christ. I'm talking to the church. We're all going to stand before God. And the Bible said we'll give an account of ourselves. But he said, let every man take heed how he builds their own. Every man's going to be rewarded according to his own labor. It's not talking about I'm working for my salvation. That's not what he's talking about. He's talking about after you're saved, take heed how you live your life for God. Jesus said, lay up your treasures in heaven. Verse 11, for other foundation can no man lay that is laid, which is in Christ. Jesus is the foundation. There's not another way to heaven. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me. He's the foundation. He's the way to heaven. There's not another way. The Bible said, there's not another name given under heaven whereby men must be saved. Jesus is the way. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. He's the way to God. Verse 12, he said, if any man build upon this foundation, gold, silver, precious stone, wood, hay, or stubble. He named six building materials. Gold, silver, precious stone, wood, hay, or stubble. There's six building materials that's going to be built upon. Well, three of them is combustible. The wood, hay, and stubble, when the fire tries them, and the Bible said the fire will try our works. Listen what it said, verse 13. Every man's work shall be made known. Every man's work shall be made known. What we do for God, it will be made known. What you do for God, it will be made known. God said, every man's work will be made manifest or will be made known. Here's what he says, for the day shall declare it. We're going to stand before God at the judgment seat of Christ. Our works are going to be tried by fire. Here's what it said. Every man's works shall be made manifest or made known. What you've done for God, it will be made known. Here's what it says. For the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire. The fire shall try every man's work of what kind it is. And he said, there's six building materials. Precious stone, gold, silver, wood, hay, or stubble. He said, the fire will try your works, and it will be made known. Now listen what he says. If any man work abide, he's talking about after the fire of God tries your works. If any man's works abide, he that he has built upon. Remember I said your works are what you build upon. Jesus is the foundation. This verse said, if any man's work abides, it's talking about after the fire of God has tried it, which he has built upon. Built upon what? Jesus Christ is the foundation. He shall receive a reward. The Bible said God's going to try our works, and if our works abide, we will receive a reward. This is so good right here. This is what Jesus said. Lay up your treasures in heaven. He said, Don't lay them up here on earth. Lay them up in heaven. And I once read this in a book, and I'm not talking to anybody or putting anybody down, but I read where this man said, he said, a foolish person is only concerned about the here and now. You know, a foolish person is only concerned about that right now. But he says a wise person considers eternity. And you'd have to have wisdom to understand that. That we're here a few days and we're gone. We're in eternity. You're in eternity. You're going to be in eternity forever. So what is really going to matter is what you laid up. It's not what you have right now. You're going to lose it. I promise you're going to lose it. Everything that you have, it'll go to somebody. But what you lay up for God, it's going to be eternal. The Bible said the rust and the moth does not corrupt, and thieves do not break through and steal what you're laying up. Jesus said, every man's work shall be tried by fire. And it said, if any man's work abide or continues, talking about after the fire, he shall receive a reward. You know, payday's coming. Payday's coming. But this verse said, if any man's work shall be burned, you know, there's people who are going to have a lot of works and they're going to go up in smoke. They wasn't for God, it was for themselves. It wasn't for God, it was for themselves. If any man's work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss, but he himself shall be saved as by fire. You know, and I'm sure that every single person that's watching, you want a reward. Well, now's been your time to get it. Now's the time to lay it up. Now's the time to lay up your rewards. You know, one day God is going to call all of us home. And then your time of laying up rewards will be over. Now is your time to lay up the rewards that you want throughout eternity. Now is your time. He said, if any man's work shall be burned, he's talking about there's going to be people that their life was about themselves. They didn't consider God. I've run out of time, but he said, if any man's work abide, he shall receive reward. If you're watching, let me say this, and you've never been saved, and you would like Jesus into your heart, you say, well, I've never accepted him. I'm going to pray and just repeat after me. Say, Father, I confess my sins that I'm a sinner and I ask you to come into my heart and I ask you to be my Lord and Savior. Say, Jesus, I receive you right now. Say, come in, Lord. And if you said it and if you believed it, he's came in. To this time next week, I pray God to richly bless you and your family. Goodbye.